News Aba, oh, News Aba. There is news and there is gist. Ghana for, hey, you have done it again. You have done it again, oh. Hey, this one is a very, 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 very super hot news. Hey, oh, in fact, make sure you host something. I am telling you, I say what? Host something. Hello, gist partners. News Aba, oh, News Aba. There is news and there is gist. Hey, Ghana for, I don't know what to say. Eh? As I said before, this is a very, 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 very super hot news. Hey, I'm just feeling the news like I dey feel the news well, well. Before we jump into this super hot news, if you know you're not following Sandra's Joyful Space, you are missing. I'm just looking at you and I'm like, ah. It's like you don't want to have fun. You don't want to have fun. Please hurry up and check out Sandra's Joyful Space. Thank you very much. So guys, this news. Hey, even though you are very, very excited about this news, please, Tennessee, just sit down well. Because this news is super, super hot. Please do watch this news to the end because you don't want to miss any part or any details of this news. Hey, you don't want to miss it. Let's just jump right into this super hot news. Ghana ranks third in Africa nuclear development race. when I'm reading this like this, I don't like it. Let me take it again. Ghana ranks third in Africa nuclear development race. How did this sound to your ears? It may be the same way. When I heard the news, I said, this one is what? It is super hot. Anyway, guys, let's just continue. Ghana is ready to invite bids towards the negotiation of a contract to set up the first nuclear power plant. According to the International Atomic Energy Agency, the country's current position falls within milestone 2, the penultimate milestone to commissioning and operating a nuclear plant in Ghana. These places are behind only Egypt and South Africa, and ahead of Nigeria in the latest African nuclear development race rankings. I'm not the one who did the ranking, no. That's what they've said. So the first position is Egypt. Second, South Africa. Third, Ghana. Mepacho, let's continue. The Ghana Nuclear Power Program, formed in 2012, seeks to ensure the smooth implementation of the Ghana Nuclear Power Roadmap towards the commissioning of the first nuclear power plant in Ghana by 2030 to support baseload power demand and provide cheap power for industrialization. The decision to revive interest in nuclear energy and its associated technologies was on the back of a report of a presidential committee in 2007, which recommended the incorporation of nuclear power into the energy mix for Ghana. Ghana Nuclear Power Planning Organization was subsequently established to steer the implementation of a nuclear energy program to address all the issues associated with nuclear planning, and this is under coordination by the Nuclear Power Unit of the Ministry of Energy. At the 26th United Nations Climate Change Conference in Glasgow, Scotland, Energy Minister Honorable Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh, in a panel discussion, said in response to a question on nuclear energy that Ghana's energy mix has significant contributions from renewable energy sources, particularly hydro, which forms the base load of energy in the country. According to Dr. Prempeh, due to the growth in demand and the incidence of climate change, the large hydro dams have become unreliable and cannot meet baseload demand in the near future. He said nuclear energy is the only clean baseload power that will meet the energy source criteria for the country, given that Ghana is mindful of our commitment to the Paris Agreement not to contribute to the increase in carbon footprint and her determination to provide baseload power. The Mahia South Member of Parliament also intimated that a nuclear power plant built in any part of the continent should be considered as a replacement for a possible fossil fuel power plant, as this is a step towards global decarbonization. He called for a comprehensive program with funding to be initiated for nascent countries to enable them to build capacity to address all the 19 infrastructure issues required by the IAEA for such countries. Ghana 4, that's the news. So Ghana has been ranked third in Africa for nuclear development race. So this is something that, you know, Ghana has been planning to do for the longest time. They have been working towards it, and right now they are making headway. So now they have done a ranking, and Egypt came first, South Africa, then Ghana. At this point, Mepacho Bomsen. Bomsen. Just begin to give a round of applause to Ghana. You guys are what? Moving forward. You guys are what? Just breaking boundaries, breaking limits, making things happen. You guys are making the move. Yes, people will say, okay, how does this help us? So, what does this do for us? So, as you know, nuclear power is the use of, you know, nuclear reactions to produce electricity. So this will be built to help to generate electricity in Ghana, which right now is not ready. They have not yet finished it. They will do it. They are working on it. And it is quite expensive. Yes, it's very expensive to build this plant. Like, it's not small money. They are building it. But at least they've made a great improvement that has even brought them to the third position. Like, easy. If it's easy, let them do it. It's not easy, guys. So as the Minister of Energy stated in the news, he said that due to the growth in demand, like, you know, Ghana is growing, there's a lot of people, the place they grow well, and also the incidence of climate change, the large hydro dams that they are using right now, it's becoming unreliable. Like, in the future, it might not be reliable anymore. So they are trying to think ahead for the future. What is the way forward? What is the way out? In 10 years' time, in 20 years' time, in 30 years' time, when these large hydro dams cannot, you know, take the whole country, cannot supply us enough electricity, what is next? That's why they are making plans to build this nuclear power plant. Yes. And it's not easy to build such a plant. It's not easy. Go and do your research. But they also made an interesting comment during the news, which I was like, you don't mean it. He said that this is to support, you know, the baseload power demand. That means it's to support, you know, the large hydro dams in the near future. And also it will provide cheap power for industrialization. Guys, who doesn't want it cheap? Don't tell me that you don't want it cheap. So when I saw these things, I was like, wow. And this will also help towards global decarbonization. If you ask me, this is a great plan. This is a wonderful plan. Because there was a research I was reading, and they said nuclear energy has public health benefits. Like, it has helped to reduce, you know, air pollution. So this is a good idea. This is a great idea. If they are doing this, and at the long run, it will help to reduce air pollution. It's good though, because you are walking on the street, you think the air you are breathing is fresh air. The things where they inside the air where they breathe. Mouth no fit talk and finish. You're just inhaling every day. You're just, you know, taking it inside. It's only God that is saving us. So this will also help to reduce air pollution and a lot more. And I was also reading an article which was speaking about, you know, the disadvantage, because everything that has an advantage will have a disadvantage. So this was what he said. It was like, exposure to radioactive waste can be litter. It's not good for us to be exposed to radioactive waste. They went further to do more research, and they were like, the public risk of exposure is very low. Meaning that even though, yes, this radioactive waste can be litter, but our exposure to it is very low. We don't come in contact with it like easily. So it's a better option. So when it comes to air pollution, decarbonization and all that, this is a better option. Yeah, this is a better option. So that is it, guys. When I heard the news, I said, my partners must hear this. If I don't bring it to my these partners, who will I bring it to? No. Who am I going to bring the news to? So quickly, I was running. I said, no, I have to bring this news sharply to my these partners. So if you have watched this point, I say thank you. And if you are on this channel, I have not yet subscribed. I don't know what to say. All I will say, me pacho, help me hit that subscribe button. And hit notification bell, let you do background. But when there is news like this, nobody will tell you. You will hear with your ears. You will see with your eyes that, news Abba. There is news and there is gist. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for your love, your support. God bless you all, and see you all in my next video. Bye.